but they didn't know that the cow had a little calf in her. It had two legs joined together like this, and had two heads and two necks, and they had the things mounted, had it stuffed. They had it on a stand, and they kept it back there in the back of the butcher shop.
The meat shop there? Oh,
yeah.
Damn.
Two-headed calf. It stood up about like that big, you know.
Do you know that my Jody has a pickled pig in a great big pickle jar? The jar's about this big around, about this tall, and she's got a two-headed pig that she delivered out on the farm. She did, and it has two heads, two snouts, two mouths, two everything here, and it has 2 feet here, and it's got some feet in the back of this body. It's a weird, she's got it pickled, she's got it sitting on top of her cabinet in the kitchen. It's the ugliest thing you ever saw.
Pickled pig feet.
Yeah. She took it to school, the boys took it to school for biology, you know, and everything. But it's the ugliest thing you ever saw in your life. It really is. She's got pictures of it. If I could get a hold of her, I'd like to show you those pictures. It is ugly.
Speaking of
a two-headed something there, it's gross. Thank you very much. I'm off now. Munchie was Mom's second cousin.
There you go.
You know, she was a Sokup. He is a Sokup. Wasn't Leo too?
Yeah, so we'd have been grand something.
Yeah. Okay, so Tmuchichka, who was she then?
She was a Kepka.
Yeah.
She was a Kepka. Okay. Uh-huh.
And she was all... The Kepkas were kind of related to the Madisons and stuff, weren't they, Leo? Or were they?
That and the Vopas and Hobart.
I think they're
all
kind of...
Some kind of a blood in them, you know.
Yeah, something, yes.
Tmuchik is such a
good old, honest,
guy.
Bohemian blood, that's what it is.
Every time Tmuchik walked into the house, the first thing he did, of course, was that bellowing laugh.
Yeah.
Oh, it was wonderful. I'd never heard a laugh like that since.
Nobody else has.
Uh-uh. And he would just laugh.
They
in his
used to
stomach
call him Laughing Tony.
Yeah.
And there was somebody that lived in the south part of town that later on in life, his brother or his sister shot his brother or something back there because shot him right in the thing.
Yeah.
Like shot his testicles off because he was messing with his girlfriend or something. It was crazy. But that they lived in the south part of town. But I don't know who it was. It was one woman and two men. And the one had this mustache, but it was one of those mustaches that come around like this, just round.
Yeah.
And Dad always say, oh, here comes Swallowed a mule and his tail sticking out. And I'm scared death of that man. Because I'm just a little old kid in the bakery and he'd play like he was coming around the counter to get me, and I'd just be petrified. No, this man with the mustache, and I'd be playing out in the yard, and they'd come in their Model T, to town from the south, and I'd run into the house real fast, because I was afraid he's going to come get me. I was so scared of that man, just petrified.
Oh, my God. What was his name?
I can't think of it. Mailer. Was it a Mailer?
Could have been. There are lots of Mailers around.
It wasn't in relation to Bob. This was a different type mailer.
Different mailer?
I think it was. I'm not positive of that. I'm not sure. Yeah.
Anna Sokup.
Now, Anna, who was Anna Sokup?
She was Mamie Jarrus's sister.
Okay.
Yeah.
And she lived on the corner down the street across from the Hoax, right?
Mm-hmm.
That was Hard Belly.
That was Hard Belly.
And Hard Belly used to walk in front of our house. Where did she go? Where would she go?
Dad.
Would she... The dad called her that. Where did she work? She would walk every day. She'd walk by the house. Did she
Gregor's
have a job?
Gregor's store. I think.
Yeah, Gregor's.
Was it Gregor's?
Honey Gregor.
Honey Gregor.
Yeah.
She used to walk back home after work, and Dad would look out and say, "Oh, there goes Hard Belly home."
The reason it was Hard Belly, she had this coarse.
She was flat.
Yeah, that's the way she was.
It looked like a tube around here because she had this corset on. It looked like this part of her was like in a barrel or something. Tube.
Yeah.
Dad called her Hard Belly.
Oh,
gosh. He had names for everybody.
I'll tell you what, well, Anna Sokup was... straight check, get
Where
it checks.
Water. I'm getting some water on my feet.
Straight check, get
Probably
it checks.
From
something.
Okay, Stanichek, Janicek was the guy with the parrot, right?
Yeah. But Anna Sokup was his, I don't know, I think it was a niece. Because she lived there.
She lived with Stanichek, Janicek?
Well, Stanichek, he was done and gone dead.
Oh.
Yeah, see.
Stanichek, they're gone and gone.
There's Muchik and Muchichka. I was to tell that one. I don't know. I don't know.
Oh my God.
That was terrible.
Well, there's
that.
No, there's more, but I can't think of it.
I
right
can't
now.
Either, Leo. I'm trying.
But he goes.
Did he? He didn't have a name for this. Was it Anapatia that came by and said thorn among the roses? Or who was
thorn
it that
what?
Said that? Maybe Mary Horsky?
Oh, Anna Dobek.
Anna Dobek? Oh, maybe. I'm not going to argue.
Mary Dobek. Not Anna, Mary Dobek.
Thorn among the roses?
Yeah, she was the, she worked for the Wilson World.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And we were sitting there, and Leo was sitting there with, wasn't it you that was sitting there with Mom and me? And there, we were all women, I think, but you.
Yeah.
And she walked by, she says, well, thorn among the roses.
To Leo?
Uh-huh. Yeah. That kind of hard belly looking thing there.
There she is with the big hat.
I was just going to say,
right there.
There it is right there.
With the big hat. Right there with the big hat.
Oh, yeah, you special.
Isn't it?
Yeah, that's it. Call the exterminators.
Who's the fullback for Notre Dame over here on the right? The lady with the black dress with the real...
What are you guys doing there?
Your uncle.
Get over there, Edna.
No, I'm not doing this. No more. I'm tired of it. No pictures, Marianne.
But I need stories. Mark wants stories. Frankie, what's going on?
I had no idea.
Rich, what's going on?
Leo,
what's going on?
What's going on, what?
Yeah, over there. What did you see?
I didn't see anything. Anybody I recognized, they're all a bunch of old fogies.
A bunch of old fogies?
Yep.
Can't imagine that.
I don't mess with old people.
But I don't have it on video, see? I need to hear this story.
Well, we sat down to eat dinner. And Daddy was sitting here at the end of the table. Mom was here.
Mm-hmm.
I was here. And I don't remember whether Leo, I think Leo was in the service then.
Yep.
And the twins were here and Rich. And I had just gotten this green bubble gum. And it was something new and different because we always had pink bubble gum.
Mm-hmm.
And we sat down and I was a-chonking this bubble gum at the table. And Daddy looked at me. And he never very, very seldom got mad at me. And he looked at me and he said, Edna, get that gum out of your mouth. And when he said that, I took it like this, and I stretched it, and I just wrapped it around his nose like this. And instead of him getting mad at me, he laughed. And Mom never did get over it. She says, you could poop in his hand, and he wouldn't say a word. She really did. He was young. He would eat, like, if he had mashed potatoes and gravy, he would eat mashed potatoes and gravy. Nothing mm-hmm. else on his plate. Mm-hmm. Then he would eat a piece of meat.
Mm-hmm.
You could not mix... You know, put all the food on his plate because he didn't want anything touching.
Who's this, Rich?
So Mom
Rich.
Bought him a divided plate. And that still didn't work. I mean, he still didn't like that. He wanted to eat one thing at a time. And this is true. This is true.
I don't know that. Hey, all three together.
It has to
be. All three. You know, always one bite. The last bite's going to be all the good stuff together, yeah.
There must be a reason for it.
Well, there must be a reason for that.
Well, I came from a dysfunctional home.
Determined who's going to get which piece.
Always.
Oh, absolutely.
Never,
wasn't it?
Absolutely.
And that's
Rich,
why I never
Rich
had
got it. The drumstick.
Right.
You got
the thigh.
And I got the other thigh,
yeah,
which
right.
we call the side ache.
Side ache.
Remember that?
That's side ache.
And you
yeah.
got, what part did you
oh,
get?
The wing.
I always got
the wing.
Mom got the wing.
Mom
always had the back.
The back, and I got the wing.
The wings. Okay.
And Dad got the white meat.
Fran had the white meat?
Or wing.
Oh, I think she had the wing.
I think so too.
What did Dad have?
Always
the white meat.
Yeah.
Always.
The white meat.
Did he really?
Yeah.
Did he?
Always the breast.
Oh, because Mom always got that back or
Yeah. To this day.
And that's all she would take.
To this the last day. Thing, oh, I'm, that's my piece now. To this day, this is no lie, I do not eat white meat because I have never been used to it. Everybody fights over white meat. I don't.
Yeah, no.
Same
I don't
with
either.
Turkey, I eat dark meat.
I like the thigh to this day, too.
Do you?
Yeah.
I like the wing in the back.
Then, at the end of the meal, when everybody's done, there's one piece. Dad grabbed the ribs.
Yeah.
And he'll sit there and he'll pick a rib, he'll chew it off.
Is that right?
Every little rib he'll pick off.
He sure
every
did.
Every rib. He'll clean that doggone thing like an ant would clean a bone.
I don't remember that
last
part.
Thing.
Yeah, he did. He did.
The fact.
Do you remember?
And then later on in the evening, it'd be a cup of milk and soaked bread in it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Can you imagine one chicken for a whole family?
Leo, do you remember when Mom used to take chicken feet,
yeah.
Not the legs, the feet,
yeah.
And the head.
Yeah.
And they would take the beak off and get the eyes out.
Yeah.
And they would take this and they would boil it with rice, I think.
And
yeah,
we'd fight over the brain.
A little piece of carrot and celery. And everybody loved that brain. It was wonderful. Yeah. It was wonderful.
Hey, come on, Mary, I keep
and
it rolling.
And the
there.
Only time, and every time, listen to
cameras
me.
Cameras go like this.
Hey, listen to me. The only time that we really had our fill of heads, of chicken heads, was when Mom butchered chickens and was freezing them.
No,
and she saved. Well, she also froze them later on. She'd keep the heads and she'd cook them all, and then we could all have a head. And them feet were nothing but gristle, but we'd just eat them things.
Between the toes and
and Dad, one time, they killed a chicken or something, and he brought these feet in the house, and he got those tendons, and he was pulling them. They were going like this, and he was going around the house scaring people with them feet. I think Fran was just a little bitty thing. He had these tendons. He'd pull them, and them toes were going like this. I'll never forget it. One day I went to a ball game. Listen to this. One day I went to a ball game. And remember that metal table we used to have in the kitchen that was on the back porch later?
Okay,
metal thing was in the kitchen. It was our kitchen table, and I had gone to a ball game, and I came home, and everything was dark. And I turned the kitchen light off, and here was this damn pig sitting in the middle of that table looking at me like this old dead pig head. They had bought it to make Ethernet, and Dad put it there to scare me, to scare the hell out of me. I'm telling you, I never saw such goofy people. Dad was funny. He really was. He was a comedian if there ever was one. Remember what we had? We had those little rags. She would sit, she would cut little rags, little square rags like this. Mom did flat, Grandma. And we have a whole box of little rags, and that's what you wiped with.
Yeah,
but in this outside toilet.
In the toilet? In the outside toilet?
Yes. That's what you wear, these little rags.
Yeah, but then I graduated, I think, to the Shadowbuck catalog.
Uh-huh.
Shadowbuck. A little slick, but other than that.
Boy, she would go out there in the middle of winter.
Well, she used a potty.
Well, she used a potty,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, but then she would go out and, you know, get rid of it out there.
Yeah.
But it was so damn cold. And the snow was deep, you know.
I know.
Yep. I pass.
I pass on that.
Look.
See, they used to potty outside and eat in the house. Now they potty inside and eat outside.
Pretty much true.
They had a prisoner, and they put him in jail, and the jail was over there by where, in the old lot there where the Lutheran church is now. And they put that guy in jail for not paying his poll tax. All right. So for some reason or other, he got out of that jail. Marshall Lowe found out about him without saying boo or what. Took his gun and shot him. Shot him right in the groin. Right here. Loaded him up in the back end of the pickup, but by the time he got to the hospital, he was dead.
They shot each other.
And,
No. I thought both of them were dead in the back alley.
No.
Because Mom put me upstairs because I had a little man in the dog buggy dressing the cat.
Nah.
She wouldn't let me go outside.
No, because after that, I was riding my bike on the street there and in Wilson, and Marshall Lowe is going to give me a citation for riding a bike on the sidewalk.
Well, I thought they shot each other.
Nah.
I don't know where I got that story, but I thought they both of them shot.
Now, supposedly there's supposed to be a bullet hole in our garage, you know, on the alley side, that I looked all around. I never found a bullet hole anywhere.
It happened
Mom
right
claimed,
there.
Mom claimed that there was one, but I never did find it.
You had some experiences that you tell about, too, at the house that dealt with the supernatural. Remember that story?
Well, but that was the black lady.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Are you convinced of that?
Oh, I'm positive of it.
You know it happened in your own
life. Oh, absolutely.
Tell us about
it. I have no doubts about that whatsoever. None whatsoever.
How old were you at this time?
The twins were still on, still taking bottles.
So you were a teenager?
No, because I was only 8 when they were born.
You were a teenager.
Maybe 10.
Pre-teen,
yeah. I was probably 8. Oh, see, the twins were taking the bottles, so they were, oh, let's see. Mom and Dad went to Missouri. It was somebody's funeral there, but I don't know who. It had to be Uncle Eddie, Uncle Otto, Grandpa, or Grandma, because that's the only funerals that were at that time. That was one of the four. I was over at Grandma's. Leo was there too, weren't you, Leo? Or did you go to Missouri that time?
I went to Missouri.
Okay, well, I was over at Grandma and Grandpa's, and the twins were there also. We had to stay there while they were in Missouri at this funeral.
Fran and I were there with you.
Huh? Yeah, you were babies, little babies.
You keep saying the twins, you know.
Yeah,
that's one of
well,
them.
Well, anyway, they had these, you had your Even Low Diddy bottles. They were glass. And one of you dropped one and broke it. Grandma said to me, does Mom have any more bottles over at the house? And I said, probably so, because she kept extras. So I went over, she says, well, why don't you run over to the house and get another bottle? And I said, okay. So I did, Frank. I went over there, and I went in the back door, went in the bedroom, opened the bottom drawer of her dresser, and that's where she kept all of her baby things. I got a Diddy bottle, and as I started to go to the out the door, which was toward the hall, you know, this black lady came around like if she had come from upstairs and came around and went in the dining room. Now, when I'm talking black lady, it was nothing but black veil. It was like black chiffon.
Yeah, but it wasn't a black-skinned lady.
No, it was no skin.
Dressed in black.
There was no skin.
Kind of
all I saw was this part and this black chiffon stuff. It was just like waving. Well, it scared me so bad that I slammed the door. I took this dresser, and that dresser weighed a ton. And I was just, 10 maybe, if that old. And I pushed that dresser against the door. I went out the south window, which we had a bed on the porch. Remember when we used to have a bed on the porch that we slept out there in the summertime?
Kind of like a day bed.
But it was iron. And I pushed the screen, but you could only push it, and they measured 6 inches. And I squeezed through that 6-inch thing fast. I just went, and I went over to Grandma's, and I couldn't breathe because I was so scared. Grandma was shaking me, and white, I was white. And she wanted to know what happened. I told her that I saw something that looked like a black lady over there. So Anna Pesha was going down the sidewalk, so Grandma hollered at her. She says, Anna, come with me. We're going over to Mary's. Edna saw something that looked like a lady over there. So they went to every bed, the junk room, under the bed, and Anna Pesha, and I went with them, and Anna Pesha says, if you're under there, you better get out. You know, Anna had a hair lip and whatever. And she was, if there's anybody here, you better get out right now. And she was just braver than hell, you know. And that's the end of that. We found absolutely nobody. But Grandma, after we got home, Grandma sat there and she wanted to know, and I told her, and all she did was like this, yeah, like if she knew what, she said something about that sometimes when people die, that there's a spirit, you know, that doesn't go where it's supposed to right away, that makes its rounds or whatever, she said. But this is the truth, as God is my judge, this was not, because I wasn't scared to go over there. You know, you might say, well, you were scared, you were looking for, you know, to get scared, but I wasn't afraid. I had nothing to be afraid of. But boy, I was afraid after that, terrible. Mm. So then, several years later, Mr. and Mrs. Hushka, Mr. Hushka was dead, but Mrs. Hushka was upstairs asleep at Mrs. Riley's house, and Mrs. Riley was sitting in the kitchen. Now, she told me this, and she was sitting there drinking coffee, and she saw a little man kind of run across the floor, and she said it looked like a teeny leprechaun, maybe about a foot high, and it was a full man, and it scared her really bad, because she knew she didn't have any rats in the house, you know, or any animals. And so she didn't think too much of it. When she went upstairs to get her clothes to get ready for bed, Grandma Hushka was dead in bed. She had died in her sleep. Mm-hmm. So, that's take strange. It for what it's worth.
Yeah. Okay, Mr. Smart Aleck, what's your name?
Frontal.
Frankie.
Frenchie Shake.
Frenchie Shake. What'd you say?
Frenchie Shake.
Okay.
Is that thing, that thing talks?
I talk. And that picks it up.
Oh. What do you say? What's your name again? You there hiding behind the roses. What's your name again?
I'm Evan. You
with the blue eyes.
I'm the baby.
You're the baby.
Of the family.
Yeah.
I'm the baby of the family.
Yes. And your name is?
God, I don't know.
Ricardo?
Ricardo.
Okay.
Come on. You have a last name on here?
You there, handsome. Well, what's your name?
Yasem Leo Cheng.
Leo Cheng.
In whom you are well pleased. I am Leo Cheng, your brother-in-law.
All right. Hello, Leo Cheng.
That's the least of my choice.
Are you Sarah Lee? What is your name here?
Everybody loves Bluebell.
I'm the pretty one.
You're the pretty one.
And the slim one.
And the slim one.
You're a good cook.
We know that.
Because I knew I wouldn't get pie if I came down here.
Yes, you do.
That's for sure.
You do.
We've got Edie's and Briars.
And we're preparing themselves to come to America. There was, Grandma was a little child, and her father and her mother and her... it would be her great-grandfather and great-grandmother. We're preparing to come over. They dried beef, made beef jerky. They dried fruits, like plums, to make prunes out of, to carry them over on for the trip. And after they got here, they boarded this Platetnik. The Platetnik is a sailboat. With how many people it'll carry, I have no idea. It took them 17 days, or 14 days, to come over and landed at Ellis Island. Then they were, people on the boat were dispersed to different areas. Some of them took other boats and went around southern Florida, came around to the Gulf, and landed in South Texas and Louisiana. The German people, most of those landed in Louisiana. Grandma's people took the northern route and went to Chicago, where they were dispersed to areas in central Kansas. And there they homesteaded, got the property from Union Pacific Railroad, and set up farming. From then on, everything was good. They borrowed money from the railroad. They, after they got settled down and everything, they repaid the Union Pacific Railroad with commodities, such as wheat, potatoes, whatever. And that's about just about the size of it until I was old enough to know different things about it. So that's it so far as I can say.
Wonderful.
No, it's cloth, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Plutinic. Yeah.
Yeah, they came on a Plutinic.
Do you have any idea what the ship looked like? Was it a four-master or?
It was a large one. It had to be.
It would have to be a
seagoing vessel. It had to be very, very heavy.
Do you know how many people it held to come over, or how many people came?
She said there were lots of them. Now, as far as I remember, when I was speaking with her, she never did specify the number of people that came over.
Okay, now when they left Chicago,
Yes.
Some of them came as far as Missouri and then into Kansas. This was Kansas territory at the time,
yeah,
wasn't it?
Yeah,
it was
yeah.
not a state.
Right, it was all Kansas.
So we're talking 18, what, 18?
Well, way back, God. Well.
Did we come become a state in 1860?
Okay, she came off, she's supposed to have been, I believe, 6 years old, five or six. She died at the age of what? 80-some degrees.
Yeah. 87 or so, yeah, I don't yeah. know a number.
And anyhow, you can decipher that, Frank. You got, yeah. you got your head. You can just about figure out
okay.
the answer to the question you asked
so,
me.
Well, the reason I'm asking is, that was the Civil War going on at this time then? We were fighting the North and the South was fighting.
Chances are.
It would have been, and I wonder if that had any effect on their movement or their settlement. Because Kansas, as I recall, yeah, Kansas, as I recall, was a neutral state,
right,
wasn't it?
Right. Kansas, the whole Kansas territory.
Yeah, the whole
which
territory.
Which involved what is now what about four? One, two, three, four. About four states would it be, Frank?
I guess so. Kansas, Nebraska, maybe Colorado was
involved
in that.
Yeah, that was all Kansas territory.
And I don't know whether Oklahoma was or not. There's a pretty good settlement of Czechs in northern Oklahoma.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you take Yukon.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Yukon, Oklahoma. I would say that's the Czech capital of Oklahoma.
We stopped, Marianne and I stopped there on our way from Colorado there.
Yukon.
That's thing about coming over. Do you know that? I wish
that Sam Hill I did.
You don't either, huh?
Because it was so hard to converse with Grandma.
I know. She tried to speak English.
She tried to tell you. But then she used a whole lot of this here high check, you know, which is altogether different. You got your high and low. Just like your high and low German.
Mm-hmm.
And you cannot understand. And she used a whole lot of that, I would say the high, or it could be the low. And a lot of that stuff she'd tell me, I'd go nod my head yes and all that, shake my head no, and she'd keep on talking, but then I'd ask her, sotto bill of this here, sotto bill of dumb and all that, and then she'd try to say a little bit of English and get all mixed up. Mm-hmm. So you really didn't know what in the Sam Hill you're doing.
You know, I never even stopped and thought about it, but Grandpa came, for some reason or other, I think they did.
I've got
for
the feeling.
Some place in the brain here, I think so too.
I've got that feeling too, when they were just youngsters, and where they could have met, I have no idea. Mm-hmm. It's probably in the shuffle somewhere.
Well, when Grandma came over then, they had to settle in some sort of a location. They had to build a home.
Yeah.
This is where the sod house mm-hmm. became a real important part of.
That was a very important thing, yeah.
And is it true, we were talking about Blood Creek, is it true that there was some discrepancy with them, that settlement, the white settlement, and the Indians? And they said that Blood Creek, that creek ran blood? I mean, run...
Well, that was the name because there were battles there, yeah. There was blood in there. That's where it got its name, really. Okay.
Was that all Indian, or was that between the Indians and the whites?
Indians and the whites.
And the whites. Uh-huh.
Okay, when they were... In that sod house, there were Indians. Now, this is Grandma told me. There were Indians that approached. They had approached the house. But they never did attack or anything like that. So they just stayed inside, and then pretty soon they walked away.
Mm-hmm.
Another instance, I believe they gave them some food of some kind.
Yeah, I remembered some of that stuff that's coming back to me now. I remember that. I can remember them when she said, I'd ask about Indians, and she said, yes, they came, but they didn't. Come in the house, or did they?
No, they thought,
anything.
They
just
out.
Came
I think
toward.
They gave them bread. They gave them something to eat. I know that. And they were just a small group of. There was no, you know, whole tribe or anything like that. They were just running around in small groups. Not no big thing. I'm gonna start a great big war, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And they were perfectly harmless. They really didn't do anything. Nothing bad.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Hmm.
And then who built the house on the farm there?
Now, that was a joint venture. That was the other settlers also.
Well, see, I
they
don't
all
know any
chipped
of this.
In. They all chipped in. They got all this limestone. They went and they they stripped all the sand and all the dirt off of this here limestone bed. Then with hammers and chisels and all that, we're breaking up into blocks. See, there's a limestone bed there, on right there on the farm.
And that's what they call natural stone, don't they?
Yeah, yeah.
Natural stone.
Natural limestone.
Oh. And,
they got their mortar. They had, they black wolf was kind of existed there a little bit, kind of. But somebody, somewhere, I think it was, they said across the river, they got the cement, you know, to put that thing together. So all the farmers, or all the settlers, got together. One helped one to build a house, and they all got together, the others to build theirs. See, Grandpa and Grandma wasn't, Grandma's house wasn't the only sod house there. There were others located, like where, I guess it was the Barters that were across the fence over there. They had one there on their property. So we found the deed, you know, what the...
That's what Frank said. And how much did the land sell for?
$9 an acre.
Isn't that something?
They had to give $144, but the whole thing cost $1,460.
My goodness.
For 160 acres.
Yeah, for 160 acres.
It's pretty cheap.
Yeah.
You pay more than that for 1 acre now.
No kidding.
Oh, tell me.
Now, Rich and I can attest to some people that died on the farm and were buried there, because he and I both had to plow during harvest.
We had to plow.
You probably did too.
Okay. Do you know the story on that?
No. I'd like to hear it.
Okay. After the home was built, all right, they was all adults and everything, all right. And out on the, they had a screened-in porch. And on that screened-in porch, they had a vine that was growing. And that vine looked like possum grapes, you know, when it produced fruit. Little clusters of nice blue-looking grapes. These two children came from the other family, I guess visiting or whatever. Went over and ate those grapes. And two of them, the two died. All right. They packed them in ice. They where they got the ice? I guess they went to Nublack, back to Black Wolf, got some ice, and packed them in ice and in a kind of a tank and everything like that. Until they dug the graves on the corner, just as you turned in to...
On the right-hand side.
Right.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And they buried him there. They built wooden boxes and put him in the wooden boxes and...
See, there was no embalming in those days, and they had to disperse of their bodies immediately, you know.
Yeah, so they left that plot, not too much bigger than this room, if it was this big. Mm.
I remember they never could plow over it or anything. They know that.
They give those kids that respect. Mm-hmm. And let's see, what else?
Can you think of anything now, Frank?
Well, that's when Grandma and Grandpa then were married and lived on the farm and had the kids. And what did they do for a living? I mean, how did they make any money?
Farmed?
Was it farming wheat at that time?
Farming wheat.
And this was all done by horse and...
Most of it, right at the beginning, was by hand.
Yeah.
Hand, of course, walking plow.
And the size to harvest it? And
okay, and to harvest. Okay, here we go. I got another one. When they harvest the wheat, they took the, that's before the thrashing machine and all that, out there on the, just northwest of the house on the farm, was a great big concrete circular thing, okay? In the middle was a post with an arm out this way. Okay. They would put a horse on it that way, and the horse would stomp, go out and stomp the grain, you know, out of the thing.
I'll be darned.
Okay. And also, they used a deal like this. I don't know what would you call
a
it.
A flail?
Yeah, to knock the grain out of the wheat head. And they'd gather up the the grain, fan off the straw, you know, pick up the grain, put it in sacks, take it to Black Wolf. And then they already had the kind of an elevator thing there, which ground there. They didn't have white flour. It was whole wheat flour. Mm-hmm. And that's what they used for baking.
Don't you think perhaps, guys, that Black Wolf was named Indian type? That sounds like an Indian name.
Yeah, it had
Black
to be.
Wolf,
yeah.
Doesn't it?
It had to be, yeah.
Yeah, that's got to be Indian. Yeah,
that's interesting because Dad hauled his wheat to Black Wolf, and we're talking many years between the time Leo was talking when Leo and I and Rich worked the farm.
Uncle Tony kept every dime of his money in the Black Wolf Bank.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
Hmm. Sure did. He
and
kept
how far away was that?
Well, just
one Pall Mall cigarette. A
couple miles.
One Pall Mall cigarette away.
I used to take the truck with a load of wheat. I light off.
It's a 3-minute cigarette, right?
Pall Mall. And when I got there, it was done. Yeah, it's about 5 minutes or
5 to 7 minutes.
5 to 7 minutes. Yeah.
Because I can walk from my complex to the store in 7 minutes.
Okay. Yeah, that's the way he goes. I said, "How far is it to the store?" And he'd say, "Well, it's tell me one cigarette or something."
Yeah, this is a long one to Pall Mall.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
The hundreds.
How long it take you to walk in 7 minutes?
Now we're debating on this Jedicek, I can't say it right now. What was the parrot deal? Where was the parrot?
On the porch.
But where?
On the south side of the house. I mean, on the east side of the house.
Is that across the street from Joe Oakes?
Across the street from Joe Oakes.
There you go. And you said something about it was in the Olds, Francis Olds.
Downtown, there was a parrot, too.
I don't know who had it.
Okay, that had to be Aunt Ann's grandmother's.
All right, that clears
what it
up.
Was. Maybe that's where they lived. I can't remember.
But Strejček Jedicek was Granddad's
brother.
I never knew him, evidently. I barely remember Grandpa.
The reason I think he was older, and I think he was dead.
Oh, he died before.
That's the only reason.
Is that right?
Because I was a damn youngster when I used to go over there.
And I can barely remember it.
Who was his wife? What was her? Do you remember her?
I don't know that either. That's nobody ever.
I can't ever recall
seeing her. Uh-uh. It was Anna. Anna lived there, didn't she? Anna.
Yeah. But I had a damn old parrot, and some bit me that one time. But I used to go over there. Why? I don't know. I can't ever remember him giving me any treats or, you know, money or anything like that. Maybe just somewhere to go. I don't know. Maybe just because it was Grandpa's
brother. Could be.
He would be able to check it. I guess you go visit him.
Well, I know I was there. I was there also. But it seems to me that there was some food involved, like cookies or something. I don't know whether Mom would bake cookies and send them down there. Could that be or something?
I don't know.
Because I can remember something, but I can now, but I never even thought about this. That's like Grandpa Kroetke. Well, I never thought about him for 100 years except for the fact that he had, when he'd sit like this, Grandpa Kroetke had this big thing, just like this. I mean, it stuck clear out like this. And I remember I asked Mom one time, I said, "What is that big thing that's hanging there?" And she said that he's ruptured. And that he never had surgery. Well, I didn't know what a rupture was. So she told me that, you know, it was a tear and probably his intestines have gone down in there. Because it was great big and I just thought it looked awful, you know. And he walked funny with that thing.
Hanging out there.
Kind of thing
hanging. I wonder what you're talking about.
No,
here,
but not that.
Old man Zawinik had the same thing, but he kept working as a blacksmith.
Oh, did he? Oh, let me
hear about Potter.
Joey, what?
Me and Joey again, good old Joey. We at times had given her cottontails, you know, because little rabbits, because she'd be like rabbits, okay. Me and Joey, we go hunting, right? And we got a possum. So we say, we gotta give her a nice cottontail, see? So So we skinned that. I didn't. Joey did. Joey, you do it. Okay. Joey, he got it. We skinned that thing, dressed it, and he cut that tail off right near to the rear end, you know, where the tail really was supposed to be on a cotton tail. So we take it over there. I give it to Joey. Joey, you take it. But I'm with you behind, okay? Tucky, hello. Hello, she laughed. Daddy Maskralik. We have a cotton tail for you. Huh. A couple of days later, she says, across the fence, Don't that be la Kralik, don't be la Bakem. That was no cotton tail, that was a possum. Yeah.
So we called her Mrs. Bakem after that forever.
I thought you did that to Grandma.
No.
Who was it to? No. Oh, I thought you did that to Grandma.
She was a little old lady, but it wasn't our Grandma. No.
Nah. Oh, she was a nice old lady. Me and Joey used to go in there all the time. She always had maybe some kind of a little...
She had that wooden fence around her house, didn't she, Leo?
Yeah, have a little dulka or something like that. She always had something for us. But hey, we're doing that tree. What's that? Hell? We took all the grease off that pocket.
Because they're greasy, isn't it? Have you ever eaten possum? Mm-hmm. Greasy.
I don't think I care for one hand.
Cutting your hair, and he would walk around in front of you and look you right. He's this far from your face.
Right.
Look you right in the eye, and he would go. And in check, he would say, "You want me to cut it off?" Tally marker.
Yeah.
And I don't know how he said that. Do you know the words?
Yeah, no, I don't know exactly, because it really doesn't make a whole lot of difference, because I jumped out of that damn chair and he didn't see me anymore.
Ran home and told Dad, ran to the bakery.
You're going
to
cut my pride and joy off. My gosh. You know, Leverka, who are squirrels. Zaitz, which are rabbits. Vomachki, who were gravy.
Yeah.
Mr.
and Mrs. Gravy. I'd like you to meet Mrs. Squirrel.
There's more. Wait a minute. There's more. Zahuts. Zahut. That's a back house. Outhouse. Who mean? Zahuts. Remember them? Zahuts and Puspuski. What would be a Puspuska?
Let's see. Puspuska.
I don't know anymore.
Get your book out.
And then we had the... Chetu Jabba lived over there east of town.
Chetu Jabba.
Okay. Cancel. In the Moravian language.
Yeah.
Because Heske Dad means...
swear to God that we have Moravians in us.
Dad always said
Moravia, Leo, some kind of I think this is true. Moravia was Bohemia, was the same country as Bohemia, but I don't know which was which came first. If it was Moravia, then it was Bohemia, and then it became Czechoslovakia,
right.
Which today is Česko, the Republic of Slovenia, in the Czech Republic. Mm-hmm. So it's gone, it's undergone, what, 3 or 4 changes in our lifetime.
4 changes, yeah.
Yeah, but Frank,
I don't like that.
I don't like that.
I don't either.
Okay.
Hopefully it would not be Czech name.
No, it wouldn't be Czech, but that's what he used to say.
Who said that?
Dad.
Really?
Dad told me that they used to spell it M-O-H-E-S-K-I. And he said it sounded too much like Jews, so granddad Moheski or great-granddad Moheski changed it. And on those days, they could just change it.
Okay, let me tell you.
Now, that's what Dad told. That's what Dad said.
Derek Houston.
Out the name.
The people with the end of S-K-Y are Jew.
Really?
They'd be Polish Jews, Czech Jews.
Russian Jews.
You said that right. Russian Jews and Hungarian Jews. Mm-hmm. They all with a Y.
Mm-hmm. Well, around
and
here, most
true, and a true blues end with a A or an I.
The I's were the Poles, as I understand, the Y's were the Czechs.
Yeah.
The Polish. Really? With yeah. I. Uh-huh. Czech. Uh-huh. Most of the Polish names. And they, no, only
and they
the
do.
I.
And they do, yes. How about this?
steering a little bit.
I'm sorry.
Isn't that a nice
boy? And she rides. Pretty good.
Trick rider. Somehow you use your brakes to stop it. Well, you're good. Mm-hmm. Ah! I bet you've been practicing, huh?
Hey Jake, a real hitching post.
Do you have any smiles? Do you have any smiles?
Smile? Come on.
Do you have any smiles?
Yeah, he's got smiles.
You got any more?
Come on.
Smile.
Quit.
I've got bugs on about everything in the house.
Jakey.
Mealy bugs on my...
Here we go. Jakey.
Can you wave, Jake?
Wave. Wave, Jake.
Is he? Mm-mm.
There he goes. Sarah.
I think I may
have
that.
Hi. Hi, Sarah.
Wait.
You tired?
Big girl?
She...
Hi.
Come on. You're supposed to be in the bathtub.
Can you sing some more?
Sing Daddy a song?
Yeah.
That's pretty. What was the name of that?
Dinosaur Song.
Oh, Dinosaur Song. Okay. Can you play another one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Apple.
Huh? Purple, yes, that's purple. Blue. That's yellow, pink, red, green, orange, red,
are you ready to get in the tub?
Aren't you getting cold?
Yeah.
Come on, your bath water's waiting. Your bubbles are waiting for you.
Mmm. Chocolate chip, huh?
Almonds.
Huh?
Almonds.
Okay. Can I have a drink? Have a drink?
No.
No? Would you like some more soup? Mm. Would you like to do it? Would you put some gravy on my cookie? Thank you. Mm, thanks. Is this my fork? Thank you. Cookies and gravy.
Looks very good, Daddy. Sarah, did you make that yourself?
Yeah,
is Tom eating with you?
Mmm. Oh, the gravy helps the cookie.
Spoons.
Give Tom some more.
I want babies.
Let me try the baby. Okay, I'm gonna set Tom over here. Need some help? Are you going to leave him here?
I'm going to make a baby.
Do you like it?
Yes.
Good? Okay. Are we through? It was very good. Can I help you wash the dishes?
Yeah.
Okay. There you are. I'll hang these up, okay?
Sarah, can you show me your smile? Oh, that's a very nice smile. Are you washing your dishes? Oh, make sure you get them clean.
Do you want to serve some to Mommy?
Huh?
Okay.
Mom.
Do I get some too? Oh, thank you, Sarah. That's very good.
You have to go sit at the table.
Is this mine?
Yeah.
Is this mine?